Hopefully you guys, I'm back. I'm just waiting for y'all to come back. I'm sorry about the audio last time. I'm gonna have to reset my computer. So you guys come on back. I'll wait for you. I don't know how long I'm gonna stay on because I am dog tired, y'all. I am. I really don't feel like wearing these freaking glasses, but it's the only way I can see you. Oh. Well, I'm 1 minute, 11 seconds, 13 seconds back into the second blog. I said, let me try this again. I'll wait for you guys to come in. Sorry about that. I had to restart my computer. So let's see who comes back and who shows up, guys, because if not, I'll stay in about 5 minutes and I'm going to head to bed. You know, there's nothing to talk about other than what I've done today. You guys have seen most of the day. So I know you're probably tired of looking at my face. And it's cool. You know, we had a lot of time within the last 24 hours. So I'm waiting for everybody to come back because I think some people are still hanging in my other live stream. StreamYard sucks. So this time I didn't put StreamYard up. I Twittered and Facebook who I'm talking to right now. I didn't text everybody because I don't, you know, it's kind of getting kind of late. And I know you guys got better things to do than watch me all night and see me all day. So you're probably tired of me already. But anyway, you know, I got love for you. That's why I'm still here. Wow. I'm just waiting for you guys because I know y'all can hear me now. Sorry about the last time. I had to restart the computer, so. So I'm going to sit here, probably drink a little glass of beer, smoke a cigarette, hang out for a few minutes, and get myself ready for bed, guys, because tomorrow morning I got to do Pilates and what's on my workout schedule? Pilates and yoga. Just relaxing. Fun Saturday day. Put up my Christmas decorations tomorrow. You see, I got the tree up, but I'm still working on it. I've been so just grinding with YouTube and I don't know, just working on my channel, looking at new ideas. And I got 3 channels set up to divide the videos I do have, which is over 1,000 now, I think. And yeah, better things, better content, Carolina Diamonds, now that I know I can, guess what, take my phone with me. YouTube changed it, y'all. We ain't got to wait 1,000 subscribers, and we can go. You got 500 now, so you can use community tab, and you can use your phone. Awesome. So if you got over 500 content creators with you right now, or people that is joining your channel, you can now use your phone. And that's what always been my thing. I just like to take my phone and go everywhere with it, you know, because I can record with it. I can pretty much just do anything I want to. And if you got an iPhone like I do got, man, it's like your personal assistant, you know, when it comes to things like that. But, you know, I found out today you could live stream on Instagram. I always thought Instagram was a type of platform where you just put pictures up and, you know, you comment on people's pictures. But I seen Katie, my friend Katie Roby, was on Instagram. I was so glad to see her, y'all. I just keep talking about it. But you just don't know how this woman has impacted a lot of people's lives. Some people don't like her. Some people love her. I mean, they didn't love Jesus. They talk about him, and he's the perfect one. So, you know, what makes us different? You know, everybody's not going to like you, and that is the gospel truth. So you got to take those trolls and let them know that they're not going to take your energy away. You're going to be positive. You're going to do you, live your best life. Don't let this stuff get to you about these little weirdos that's going to around people's channel, trying to get them screwed over, and it's just hateful, and there's no special place for those people like that. I always treat people like you want to be treated, because I tell you what, if you do good things, then good things will come back to you. Do bad shit, guess what? Bad stuff going to happen to you. Anybody like, oh, God got to curse on me. No, baby, it's a rule of karma. You treat folks wrong, you be treated wrong. So that's what I'm going to say about that, y'all. I'm looking sleepy. And I go, I know I am. I wanted to roll my hair, but my finger hurt. And with these, you know, YouTube, I love YouTube. I just love it. And I hate for anybody to lose their channel for anything. But, you know, sometimes, even I have had a couple channel strikes, I would tell you. I mean, I remember times I would tell Brandon Bull, and I would cry about it. About this time last year, I think, I went to sleep. I think I had the flu last year, and I left my doggone mute button unmuted. And I think I was watching some show on TV. I think it was Andy Griffin. They channel struck me for 30 days, man. And this is when they was changing, purging from 2016 stuff to making everything compliant from last year. I was like, what the hell, man? I was upset, but thank God I had a backup channel, but it wasn't the same. My backup channel is for what it's supposed to be for, like dogs or for dogs. So I said, man, I'm going to take a break because this shit getting to me. I started caring about numbers, and I was like, nah, man. You know, you do what you got to do. You got a voice to speak. People going to hear if they want to hear you. And that's just all I got to say about that. Oh, I am just so sleepy. Do y'all know how hard it is to talk to yourself in a computer? It's very hard. No, not really. But when you're tired, it's extra hard. So I'm just trying to wait for everybody to come back, you know, because I truly am sorry about, well, I'm not sorry. I apologize for, you know, talking in this mute, but I still didn't see what was wrong. I just had to reboot my computer, I guess, because I had it on all last night, and I got Windows 11 on here. And it does have hiccups, but, you know, it is public compliance, and it keeps me in perspective. Now I'm getting sleeping. Now I can't believe I got one pearl earring in and one out. But I remember taking it out because I have a bump. I don't know where it comes from. It's behind my ear. And I squeeze it with whitehead. It's a whitehead. I think it comes from, I don't know. I guess, I don't know. But I need to quit playing with it. And I keep, it's like a scab on it because I do have sharp nails. And it might be what's going on. Two people in the building, no thumbs up, but that's fine. I understand that, guys. It is getting late. It's getting late. Well, it's getting late for me because, you know, I've been up since, shoot, what time? I think I've been up since pretty much about 6 or 7. I've not took a nap, just grinding. Got homework to do, so I'm saving it for tomorrow. Y'all ain't talking to me, so I don't know what to say. Don't be afraid to say something to me, please. I guess I'll sit here till somebody say something. I'll go to bed with mine. Oh, yeah. Man, I was on TikTok really day. You know, I got an account, but I haven't put any videos in it like that up. There's somebody who had a TikTok challenge. I thought it was the most mundane, craziest shit in the world, man. Benadryl challenge. These little kids take 10 to 12 Benadryl. I don't know what's wrong with some of these kids. I don't know where the hell they get their mentality from, their values, but they do the most dumbest things I've ever seen. Little kids are taking Benadryl pills, popping 10, 11 years old just to have a LSD high and end up dying or going to the emergency room. Stupidity is what it is. Stupid stuff give you stupid results. You know, don't do something stupid. And then at the end, when you know good and well, and you had no right to do what you did, not suffer the complicated ramifications behind it. You know, you do something dumb going to happen to you. I hate to say that. And Lord knows I love the kids. It is what it is. But I think it was parents. And we involve ourselves more in our kids' lives than we do on being social media or something. Some of these things that happen to our kids and been getting bullied, we as parents should be able to handle, really. Because can't nobody come and stalk your child unless they're on the internet. Why the hell are they on the internet? Because you allow them to be on there. So I think the parents should be ultimately responsible for that. No matter what. Who pays the bills? Not them, you do. The good book tells me if you spare the rod, you spoil the child. That means if you don't discipline your kids and show the example, your kid's going to not be disciplined. You don't want that. You don't. I swear you don't. I got two daughters, man. I just imagine one of them coming to me and say, Mom, I got something to tell you about. And then say, well, Mom, I'm going to slap your face. What the hell? Child, you ain't ready. I brought you in this where I take you out. You know what all mothers tell us that. Well, it put us in perspective. They have to let you know when we ain't taking no jump. But anyway, that's the difference having a child in college versus in prison. Fruit don't fall too far from the tree. And my daughters, I can tell you, they doing great things. I'm not saying they better than anybody else, but I am so proud of mine. I am, man. And that the fact that now I don't have to sit here and fuss every day at them because they already finally got it, that's a great thing. And yeah, I took a Benadryl, and I'm telling you, it's making me sleep. And I should have waited to take it because I would like to go to sleep at 11 so I can get at my regular time, which is about 7 o'clock now. But normally, when I get like this in this state, you know, I'm chilling, relaxing. It's supposed to be cold. That's really why I ain't been nowhere, just chilling. I'll sleep good tonight. I really will. Y'all talk to me. I know. Well, y'all probably going to other people's channels. I understand that. So I guess I don't know. I'm trying to make this at least a 30-minute video or live stream. But my eyes are so sleepy. I don't know if I can do it or not. But anyway, I don't know what's going on. I guess everybody busy or just tired. Oh. My heart goes out to those. It's in Tornado Valley. Well, excuse me, on there on the Dust Bowl. We call it the Dust Bowl where you're in Arizona, Indiana, Chicago, places that, oh my God, they normally get cold. How are you doing, darling? Yeah. Good, I hope. You can see I'm dog tired. I'm sitting here talking out the side of my neck, trying to keep my eyes open because I just took a Benadryl and you guys know I've been live streaming all day and, hey, making videos. That's what content creators do. Always on the grind, baby. But it's the weekend. Yes, three people in the building. And I got Joni's Journey in here, my girl. Thank you for stopping in a couple of live streams. I realized when I was working on the tribute video for Miss Katie Roby, you was there the whole time, darling. And I was using StreamYard, you know, trying to use the comments like I professionally do, but I haven't been able to do that. Oh, here's an easy and beautiful Christmas decoration. Oh, thank you, darling. I've been waiting on that. But you know what? I'm gonna copy that. I'm not going to leave right now because I hate to leave my chat, but I'm copying it. I'm going to go there. Thank you so much, Joni. Thank you. That lets you know that you are the best mod ever. You're a woman about your word. I totally have forgot all about her, though. I did. And I was telling, I think Matthew Combs, I was like, yeah, man. I met Janet. Excuse me, honey. I'm talking about Janet. Guess I was watching too much Good Times. Janet. What do you call it? What was her name? Janet DeBose. One plays Bologna on Good Times. I've been watching him doing the marathon thing and oh, Lord, my scalp is itching. I just washed it too. Yeah, I got this condition on it, and it's supposed to stay on it. I'm trying not to scratch. But I've been watching them, and, you know, that's chilling because it's cold and rainy here, North Carolina. I hope you guys are warm and safe. And I'm just saying, you know, just, you know, one of those days you just don't really want to go anywhere. Just want to stay home and eat a bowl of soup. But anyway, guys, I got some good ideas now. Tomorrow I will be cooking pinto beans. And I will show you probably how to do that even when you pick the beans out. And, you know, my option is I don't just cook them straight up. I let them marinate overnight. So I will prepare the beans so that I can cook them, slow cook them, and slow cook them before I go to church and be come home and be ready. Booyah to eat. But Janice is saying, let me get my glasses on. I met Joni. I told you I've been watching too much Good Times. I need to quit that. You gave me the link. Thank you. I'm making some of them today. Oh, you are? Do you have a PayPal link for mods to post occasionally? You know what? I have not even thought about yet. No, I don't, but I'm going to get one. I'm going to get one. I really am. And I got my community. I'm not because anytime you got over 500 subscribers, guys can always go back there, post something about, you know, especially you, Joni, you're a mod. So that gives you right to go to my community channel and post something as long as, you know, it's respectable, which I know you're not, you know, like the typical trolls around here that try to raise somebody's channel and say, you know, you're with somebody and you just betray them. I don't feel that from you. So, you know, I don't feel that from anybody because it's up to me as the actual content creator owner to go behind anybody and they do anything wrong to hide it or delete it. But, you know, the one thing I'm going to tell you is that you have to go to my community tab, baby. Go, please do. I love it when you guys get involved. It makes me more involved, want to be thriving to give the quality YouTube videos that you need or want, but at the same time, keep me strong and knowledgeable and savvy that I don't make mistakes, you know? I know I'm not perfect, but at least you want to be part of my organization or you want to make money from it, and you need to learn about the company too, I think, personally. You know, this is the way it is. Any other things I like mods to do? Well, this is my theory of mods, even though I'm a mod myself on many channels. Some of you guys call, and I don't know, you do what you need to do when it comes to that, because like I said, I'm learning to be a mod, even though I am a good moderator for her channel. But, you know, I if anybody comes in the chat, it's your job to, you know, disseminate that. And a lot of people don't like when other people that we're close to time somebody out, but you got to have a tough skin here, because sometimes people come in your chat to do the most craziest things. I don't see me having any major hiccups when it comes to me going live or whatever, because I feel secure. You know, it's just something that, you know, you got to instill, you no matter what goes on in life, you got to be strong. Got to be, because don't, your weakness will get you in a situation you never thought about. And I say the best thing about overcoming anything, don't do anything stupid. Don't, you know? Any other things you like? Yeah, I would like you to.
Oh.
Sorry, hon. Yeah, all, you know, content creators are different. Just do what you need to do it and, you know, be good at it, honey. And, you know, that's just that, you know, being a moderator, you know, if you feel like it's threatening, then hey, do something about it, because I'm not going to go against my mods no matter what. Well, yeah, I will if you're wrong, yeah, but, you know your place as a moderator, honey. I know you, that you are that good. I have no problems with you cussing somebody out who hurts you or going to my community tab, posting anything, you know, as long as it's positive and, you know, you can get something from it, it's all right with me. I believe in freedom of speech. You know, I'm not Donald Trump or anybody like that. I'm just a little, and politics is not me, you know, and I try not to be around, you know, them like that. But yet and still, oh my God, I am so tired, guy. I'm talking out the side of my neck, y'all. And that's how sleepy I am. Man, if y'all ever did a 24-hour live stream, it is hard. Well, it ain't hard. First of all, you got to get your rest before you come on trying to do something like this. But I'm really proud of D9. I was sitting there watching his channel, not saying much. I was watching him on TV while my laptop was charging up, because I did leave it on all night. And it's a Chromebook. I mean, it's very durable. When you're at home, you just pretty much just want to chillax and let things catch up and, you know, charge up. Go to bed. I am, honey. I'm going to bed. I am going to bed. Oh, God. But in the morning, I am going to get up, cook me a continental breakfast. I got to wash my cars. I'm not going to wash them. Get somebody else to wash them probably. But I enjoy washing my cars. But I understand that it's supposed might be raining and a little cold tomorrow. But, you know, that's something I plan on doing. Johnny, I hear you, honey. You telling me to go to bed. I'm so sleepy. I got to put my glasses on just to read, you know. And these are reading glasses. Oh, I don't want to go to bed so early. I don't, but that Benadryl is kicking in. And I'm not helping myself to stay awake because I'm drinking this champagne and beer at Miller. Oh, man. And I'm sore too, guys. And I, oh, wow, 4 miles and you did it in a while. It really kicks your butt. But I did it. And also, you know, when it comes to mod, you know, if you guys got any suggestions, John, I'm blind to, oh, Lord, you hard to see me, these bad boys. But I will say it makes things easier. I don't have to strain my eyes or anything. But, yeah, as a moderator, I would like for you to give me more input with what you'd like to see. You know, there's a difference between a moderator and somebody who just comes to your channel. A moderator is just like your best friend. My channel's in your hands. And I give you full power of reign. I really do, because everything you see, I don't see. Chat be moving so fast, you know, slow me down, you know. You know, whatever you can do to make me a better content creator for you, Joni. And that's what I need you to help me do. And I think that's the job of a moderator, to back the person up that's hosting the show, so that one day if you decide to do your channels, and then my my subscribers can flow to you about your content. Oh, God, honey, I am so tired. My hazel green eyes and I went brown. That's when you know you need some freaking sleep. Yeah, but I'm just trying to stay up, so I want to get up so early in the morning. Well, I'm home retired, but, you know, I try to keep myself on the schedule. I really do, because one thing about it, when you got to acclimatize yourself to a work schedule, you can acclimatize, but I tell you, just be ready to get the hell out of there. You can set up a mod chat on Instagram, really, so we can chat privately and challenge stuff. But you know what? I like StreamYard. StreamYard gives me that same option, the backdoor policy. You know, you can come and talk to me by, you know, trying to get on the chat, and you have to wait. Hey, Matthew, darling. I've been tired, too. I got one of workers sleep too long. Y'all got to bear me, honey. Matthew says, I've been tired, too. I got some workers sleep too long. They sent her back home for a checkup, and I'm glad they did. Yeah, me too. I'm glad she's all right. But guess what, Matthew and Joni? I went to Katie Roby's, Miss FVKING Wonderful, and she was on Instagram. She's doing all right. So she worked out. I don't know if she lost her channel. I think maybe she got a channel strike or something, and she's working out with YouTube. And that's all I know. And, you know, when she comes back, I'll be glad to see her, you know. Oh, y'all, I'm sleepy. So in the morning, what y'all want me to cook? That's a long question, ain't it? It is. I'm trying to check myself to go to sleep and worry about cooking. I'm doing another video. Man, I love this YouTube platform. Meeting good people like you. Oh, Jesus. So what are you guys' plans for tonight? I know it might be cold and windy, and prayers going out to Indiana and everybody that's in that turbulent storm that they had today. Winds are like 70 miles an hour and shit. Come down this way, it gets like 35 or 40, so everything's legit here. But I know they can get, I know they can't get steel. I don't know if an employee can get fired, not if being called out too many times or no doubt, you know, hell yeah, because that's called malignant. Malignant is you abuse the system to obtain, you know, not a medical, but you trying to get over a company and you don't want to go to work and use that shit and excuse. That's called malignant. Yes, they can, because they can have a doctor to give you an evaluation and they don't find out anything wrong. They have the right to fire your ass because that's misleading to the employee himself. Now, different folks, different organizations. Sometimes, you know, people don't mind giving you a second or third chance. And that's what, you know, love is all about. We can't always be ourselves sometimes. Sometimes, you know, you got to take a change or whatever. But at the end of the day, just be happy about your decision, you know. If it's going to better you, do it. Do it. You got to live life to the fullest, honey, by any means necessary. Bam on that. Man, I get sleep. I start feeling silly. Yeah. But anyway, the gang stopped their channel reporting everything they could for 2 years, really. I could believe that, you know, because I've been with Miss Wonderful since the day she started. And I guess what Matthew's saying, how do you know that? Well, because she said it and she pretty much put her life out there for everybody to see. You got to get the woman credit, because can't everybody do that? Me, I can't do that. I can't get online 24/7 and explain about my life to people I don't know about. I just can't do that, especially when it comes to my health. That's a private matter anyway. So, you know. But anyway, I'm sure Joni knows, because you can watch Katie. She gives you all aspects of her life. And, you know, she has people out there doxing her, trying to take her down. And, you know, she has a bunch of haters out there. You know, I'm going to say this. You know, you can't make everybody happy. You got to make yourself happy. That's all I can say about that. Somebody sent me an email talking about, oh, you need to be a life coach. I was like, whatever. All I need to do is be me. I ain't trying to do nothing else. I'm not supposed to take me from who I am. That's why money never changed me. I don't know. I just realized I'm blessed with small things, and I thank God for the small things. Y'all, it's so quiet in this house. You can literally hear a pin drop. Yep. And guys, I see you guys coming in and coming out. And I know you've probably not seen enough of me today. Lots of haters, but more lovers. I love that. I love that. I really do. That's what the world needs right now, man. We got the pandemic going on. Damn, gas prices going up. Most highest, how do I say this? It's like we're going through a financial depression right now because of this pandemic. People are scared. They don't know the next choices. All we can do is pray for one another, you know? That's all we can do. But yeah, I am sleeping. You're right. I need to go to bed. I really do. But anyway, guys, I love you. And I'm going to go get ready to do the things I need to do around here. And then I'm going to get me some sleep. If you notice, the house is real quiet. The pups are not here. The cat's outside in the little cage, you know, that we set up for them. My daughter's going to come get Miss Kitty because, you know, I realized that I didn't know until now that I'm allergic to cats. I really am. Man, they're beautiful. I mean, not really a cat person until I met Miss Kitty with those blue eyes. She's like a cat dog, you know, in a cat body. But swear to God, she got to act like she got to defend the place. Now, that's why I like her about it. She's a little young, little wild, little baby kitten, you know, I think. But anyway, y'all. Highest inflation rate and you're right. They said the 70s, the 70s back in the 70s is really bad. You know, I can only imagine, you know, gas so high that you got to make a life decision. Should I buy gas now? Should I walk or should I sell my car because I can't feel like I don't have an outlet? But when you really put God first, you got everything. And that's just the way it is, guys. And I already see Tony. I love you so much, honey. You and Matthew, you guys are stepping up as mods, and I love that. People come through all the time, but when you turn your camera on and you decide to give the world a little piece of you, when you got supporting people like you and Matthew and you, Joni, you know, you got everything you need, great friends. And that's what it's all about for me, about money. Yeah, YouTube don't pay me enough to care about, you know, what's going on in other people's lives, because that's their lives, you know. This is my little world right here with my friends, and I'm happy with that. I don't need 1 billion subscribers and all that. I love small channels, and, you know, it's comforting. If I get to the point where I just blow up, hey, then I know I'm blowing up with. That's my persona about that. Oh, God, yeah, I'm like about 3 more minutes. I'm going to make a 30-minute video. I'm going to go in and lay it down. I love the way you said it, honey. Joni's journey. You said it right on the head. A grateful spirit is the key to happiness. And that is true. Learning that you're not perfect. You're human. You're here to make mistakes. But the thing about it is when you know you make a mistake and you can correct that, and it makes you a better person anyways. Because a lot of people think, yeah, I want to be on the top of the mountain. But I find out the best part about getting on that mountain is to climb up. You know, so... You know, the struggle is real, but, you know, it's just life experience that makes you stronger. So that's how I see it. But anyway, my good people, it's been real. I'm going to go lay down, y'all. I might, I know I said yesterday, I know I got to think about what I'm saying and, you know, so I don't make false wolf tickets to you guys. I know I said this when I was going to get up 3 o'clock and go live. Oh, my God. The spirit winning, but the body's like, girl, you need to lay there. No, I slept in for, I think I normally get like 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. You know, I guess the military got me like that, but this morning I slept in at 7 and then I went live. They're like, you still alive? I'm like, yeah, man. You know, when I get on and start doing YouTube, I get so excited. I just like lose sense of time, you know, especially when it's cold and rainy. Ain't nowhere to really go, and I got this heat up on 75, and it's getting warm. Okay, you know what? I like the way you said it. I was thinking about having as we talked this morning, Joni, I was like, maybe I should, you know, take out a particular time and call it War Stories or, you know, something like that. And that was an idea. I want to do that. I really do. And have a whole lot of veterans and people that I know to come on the panel, give you their stories too, because a lot of people love to hear about, you know, what it takes for us to be what we are in places and doing things for the military. Because, you know, you can thank people, say thank you for your service all the time. It means a lot. It does. But I think what it means a lot to hear about how we struggle to, you know, defend this country, because it ain't easy. God knows it's not, you know. There's nothing easy about getting up and knowing that, you know, you just had a baby, and 45 days later, no matter what, you have got to go somewhere for 2 years and not see them grow. That's, I think, is one of the biggest things that really touched me. My daughters, you know, I had to go, and but at the end of the day, when I come home, it's like, Mom, we understand. You know, that made them join the military themselves, because, like, Mom, if you can do it, you make me proud to be one too. I didn't want my daughters to go in. Hell no, I didn't. But they went in. They did it while I was deployed. But when they joined, it was like, Mom, we appreciate what you do, and we want to be a role model. Like I said, don't be like me. Be better than me. And that's why I want my kids. I push them all the time, and it plays out. It pays off. Now they're doctors and lawyers, and they're doing their thing. And me, you know, I'm a grandma. I get my grandbabies to take their booty home back to mama. You know, I've earned that right now, and I thank God for it. You know, I'm sure we have no idea. I'm sure you probably, you know what? Let me tell you something. We all go through what we go through in life, and you don't have to really be in the military, because I know the biggest survivors I've seen is some little kids. You know, had the opportunity to go and see, what do you call that organization that deals with kids? What was his name? This famous comedian used to run it. I'm going to tell you, St. Jude's, yeah. I have the opportunity, and one of the things I do around Christmas time, I like to go visit, you know, see the unfortunate little kids or whatever, and see if I can bring them some candy or, you know, anything to put a little smile on their face. Because, look, God say, little children come unto me. That means we got to protect them, and we got to nurture them and make sure they're on the right path, because when you don't take care of what God loves most, you know, he always have a way of putting our asses in time out, and that's something you just don't want. They call it spiritual welfare when, you know, doggone well, you're doing something wrong, and then your conscience eats you up so bad about it. So always try to treat folks like you want to be treated. You don't have to have those afterthoughts to keep you, like, when you make a mistake, like, oh, God, you want me to be so hard on yourself. Learn to be human, not superwoman or a robot or something where we just can't do. You know, people need to worry about their own stuff and clean up behind their door before they try to sweep around ours, and vice versa. You know, yeah, that's how that goes. Oh, Jesus. I must smoke me one more cigarette. I'm about to go brush and floss the teeth and put pajamas on and go to sleep. I'm supposed to be cleaning my hair down tomorrow, but if it's raining, that'll be the cause. That's why I wash my hair and throw it up in a ponytail, you know? That's free. Oh, Jesus. Man, I went to Dollar General today. Dollar General's a whole lot higher than Family Dollar, I think. I think they're higher than Walmart in some aspects. I think when Target, I love that place. You go in there, you just expect the same thing all the time, you know? Y'all can drop your links if you got channels. Matthew, I know you got a channel, but Joni, we were talking the other day. I had some friends. I think Matthew might have heard me say that. I believe you are entitled to come around. I think you earn your part. You do a lot. People don't see you sharing people out and all that. I'd like to, if you got content, I'd like to put you on the map. I really do. Even though people are trying to put me on the map now, I'm more of a, I think I'm a better moderator than anything, but I do have my times when I like to, you know, come on my platform and, you know, cook or whatever and just share ideas with you guys. And same thing in return, you know, everything you tell me, don't think I don't read my comments, Lord. I take them to heart, especially when it comes from good people like you. Yep. I'm smoking back to back, guys. When I get sleepy like that, that's what I do. But I'm gonna smoke this cigarette. And I only got like 2 or 3 more days. My quit date, I said, was gonna be next Saturday. I might make it before then, y'all. everything's getting high. I mean, lying, man. And the gas here, guys. I know you gas may be higher than what it is somewhere else, but last year, by the time gas was $1.58. Now in North Carolina, it's $3.11. Some places, $4. But thank God with Joe Biden tapping into our resources, I can see that the census is going down a little bit. So that's a great thing. It's a great thing. But Matthew, I did go by Dollar General and whatever, and no batteries, man. I'm at the game. I would love to hear more military stories because you got it, and I'm going to do that. And he was like, yes, I'm sure we have no idea. I read that part. Dollar Tree is now $1.25. Yeah, they are. What's going on? I guess, you know, since they passed this new rule with the merchants or whatever, pay taxes, I think everybody's supposed to pay taxes. Mom and pop stores, you know they're gonna be in compliance because they don't want to get their shop shut down. It's like we're in a stage now, everybody trying to shit somebody down on the struggle survive. Like you know, people trying to snatch people's channels, talking stuff about them, and they wonder what they're gonna last forever. YouTube is getting tired of that shit, man. I'll tell you right now. And they got a big purge going on, you guys. So you lose a couple subscribers, know this. They is just nothing but a dead account. Probably shouldn't even won't do you any good anyways. I mean, I can understand getting 1,000 subscribers and getting monetized before. But when you made it, you don't need anything pulling you back. You really don't. Well, y'all, I guess I've been on here more than I said I was going to do, 36 minutes. And I'm going to get out of here, guys. I love you guys. You guys have a happy, happy Friday. Oh, Lord, here we go. Mama calling already. Jesus, I'm not answering. I'm going to bed because there ain't no emergency. But anyway, guys, I'm checking out Rumble now. They don't censor. You know, I heard Katie tell me something about Rumbler. I heard Nick say something about it, too. I'm going to check it out, though. Oh, well. And Matthew, you look at it. You let me know what you think about it. I thought you had to pay for places like that. But, hell, I seen Katie have an Instagram. She was, like, doggone live on there. I was like, man, I thought all you could do is take pictures. I did fix my printer today. I was glad about that. So, now I can do my business stuff and be on the grind. Oh, God, I look dog tired. Y'all see the bags in my eyes? Better get some cucumbers and put them on my eyes. Yes, it actually does work. I don't know if cucumber has aloe vera in it or something. I don't know. But I know it's very essential in our diet. It makes you feel good and eat good and work out. Well, to me, it does. Well, you guys, I've been on here 37 minutes and 48 seconds. Two people in the building, one thumbs up. Not bad, you know. I love you guys. You guys have a pleasant evening. And I'm going to say much love and Roger out. Love you guys. All right, Matthew and Johnny, I have sweet dreams and happy holiday. Peace.